Peace and all, good beloved. Welcome to morning prayer for Tuesday, May 14th. Which made yesterday Monday the 13th. And I never understood why Friday the 13th is a bad day, but Monday the 13th gets nothing because Mondays seem far more scarier than Fridays. And so a Monday the 13th seems like it should be really, really bad. And a Friday, if Friday the 13th is bad, then Friday the 26th should be twice as bad, right? But whatever. I guess superstition is illogical. So let's begin with morning prayer. We will praise the name of the Lord, ascribe greatness to our God. Open our lips, O Lord, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Couldn't get to the bell. All right. Your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Arise, shine, for your light has come. The glory of the Lord is risen upon us. Gospel reflection. The time has come. The kingdom of God is upon us. Let us repent and believe the gospel. The kingdom of God is like yeast. A woman takes it and mixes it with flour until the dough is risen. The kingdom of God is like a buyer looking for fine pearls. When he finds one exceptional pearl, he sells everything he has and buys it. When we set our minds on God's reign, our heart on God's justice, everything else will be ours as well. Listen to Jesus, who proclaims the good news which he alone fulfills. The epistle reflection. Who are we whom God has called? Few of us were wise, few were powerful. Yet to shame the wise, God has chosen what the world counts folly. To shame the strong, God has chosen what the world counts weakness. In union with Christ Jesus, we are all children of God, baptized into union with Christ. We have put on Christ like a garment. There is no such thing as Jew or Greek, slave or free, male or female. We are all one in Jesus Christ. A lot of Psalms to choose from today. Let's do Psalm 99. Right there. Psalm 99. The Lord is king, let the nations tremble. He sits on his throne between the cherubim, let the whole world quake. The Lord sits in majesty in Jerusalem, exalted above all the nations. Let them praise your great and awesome name. Your name is holy. Mighty King, lover of justice, you have established fairness. You have acted with justice and righteousness throughout Israel. Exalt the Lord our God. Bow low before his feet, for he is holy. Moses and Aaron were among his priests. Samuel also called on his name. They cried to the Lord for help, and he answered them. He spoke to Israel from a pillar of cloud, and they followed the laws and decrees he gave them. O Lord our God, you answered them. You were a forgiving God to them, but you punished them when they went wrong. Exalt the Lord our God and worship at his holy mountain in Jerusalem, for the Lord our God is holy. Numbers chapter 22. beginning at verse 36. Oh, there you are, hidden down there. Okay. And if you remember yesterday from the story, people of Israel were moving through or getting, I don't know, the king of Moab was freaked out by Israel because they just beat up on the Amorites and some other people. And so he went to this guy named Balaam to ask him to come curse the people of Israel. And so it was the story about how Balaam, you know, gets asked and comes, and the angel that tries to stop him, and of course the donkey starts talking to him. Remember the talking donkey? And so now here we go. We're picking up from there, where the Lord basically says, you know, you can go with them, but only do what I tell you to do and say what I tell you to say. Actually, no, we will pick up. We'll begin at verse 35. So it'll be like one of those shows where it had a cliffhanger. So we'll begin with the first few minutes of the end of the cliffhanger to the resolution. So here we go, beginning in verse 35. But the angel of the Lord told Balaam, go with these men, but say only what I tell you to say. So Balaam went on with Balak's officials. When King Balak heard that Balaam was on the way, he went out to meet him at a Moabite town on the Ammon River at the farthest border of his land. Didn't I send you an urgent invitation? Why didn't you come right away? Balak asked Balaam. Didn't you believe me when I said I would reward you richly? Balaam replied, look, now I have come, but I have no power to say whatever I want. I will speak only the message that God puts in my mouth. Then Balaam accompanied Balak to Kiriath Huzoth, where the king sacrificed cattle and sheep. He sent portions of the meat to Balaam and the officials who were with him. The next morning, Balak took Balaam up to Mammoth Baal. From there, he could see some of the people of Israel spread out below him. Then Balaam said to King Balak, build me 7 altars here and prepare 7 young bulls and 7 rams for me to sacrifice. Balak followed his instructions, and the two of them sacrificed a young bull and a ram on each altar. Then Balaam said to Balak, stand here by your burnt offerings, and I will go see if the Lord will respond to me. Then I will tell you whatever he reveals to me. So Balaam went alone to the top of the Bear Hill, and God met him there. Balaam said to him, I have prepared 7 altars and sacrificed a young bull and ram on each altar. The Lord gave Balaam a message for King Balak. Then he said, go back to Balak and give him my message. So Balaam returned and found the king standing beside his burnt offerings with all the officials of Moab. This was the message Balaam delivered. Balak summoned me to come from Aram. The king of Moab brought me from the eastern hills. Come, he said, curse Jacob for me. Come and announce Israel's doom. But how can I curse those whom God has not cursed? How can I condemn those whom the Lord has not condemned? I see them from the cliff tops. I watch them from the hills. I see a people who live by themselves, set apart from other nations. Who can count Jacob's descendants as numerous as dust? Who can count even a fourth of Israel's people? Let me die like the righteous. Let my life end there. Let me die like the righteous. Let my life end like theirs. Then King Balak demanded of Balaam, what have you done to me? I brought you here to curse my enemies. Instead, you have blessed them. But Balaam said, I will speak only the message that the Lord puts in my mouth. The word of the Lord. Spoiler alert, Balaam's going to bless him 3 times. Each time the king's going to say, now try again, and this time curse him. And each time Balaam comes back with a blessing. Sorry if that ruins the story for you. Also, Darth Vader is Luke Skywalker's father. So, since I'm doing spoilers. Oh, we're doing Luke. We're in chapter 8. Beginning at the beginning of the chapter. If I can find chapter 8. Soon afterward, Jesus began a tour of the nearby towns and villages, preaching and announcing the good news about the kingdom of God. He took his 12 disciples with him, along with some women who had been cured of evil spirits and diseases. Among them were Mary Magdalene, from whom he had cast out seven demons, Joanna, the wife of Chuza, Herod's business manager, Susanna, and many others who were contributing from their own resources to support Jesus and his disciples. How far am I going to 15? One day, Jesus told a story in the form of a parable to a large crowd that had gathered from many towns to hear him. A farmer went out to plant his seed. As he scattered it across his field, some seed fell on a footpath, where it was stepped on and the birds ate it. Other seed fell among rocks. It began to grow, but the plant soon wilted and died for lack of moisture. Other seed fell among thorns that grew up with it and choked out the tender plants. Still, other seed fell on fertile soil. This seed grew and produced a crop that was 100 times as much as had been planted. When he had said this, he called out, "Anyone with ears to hear should listen and understand." His disciples asked him what this parable meant. He replied, "You are permitted to understand the secrets of the kingdom of God, but I use parables to teach the others so that the scripture might be fulfilled. When they look, they won't really see. When they hear, they won't understand." This is the meaning of the parable. The seed is God's word. The seed that fell on the footpath represents those who hear the message only to have the devil come and take it away from their hearts and prevent them from believing and being saved. The seeds on the rocky soil represent those who hear the message and receive it with joy, but since they don't have deep roots, they believe for a while and then they fall away when they face temptation. The seeds that fell among the thorns represent those who hear the message, but all too quickly that message is crowded out by the cares and riches and pleasures of life. And so they never grow into maturity. And the seeds that fell on good soil represent honest, good-hearted people who hear God's word, cling to it, and patiently produce a huge harvest. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. And may we all be that good seed today. The seed that fell on the road or the footpath, the hard ground that's been walked on by people, never had a chance. The seed could never penetrate the soil. And so Satan, like the birds, come and snatches it away, takes the word before it can even begin to penetrate the heart. Those on who were the where what was it, the rocks, believe for a while, it penetrates, they start to germinate, but they can't get deep roots because the soil is rocky, so they can't have deep roots. They're not rooted in the faith. It's all sort of superficial. And when persecution comes and difficulties come, they fall away. They wither and die. Those who fall among the thorn bushes, they can make deep roots. They grow, but the thorns choke them out. And the thorns are when the cares of the world, when the worries about money and our career, and all the other worries and concerns of life, and the pleasures, it says there in that translation as well. So all the things that distract us as well, they choke out the word from us, and the word withers and dies and bears no fruit. But those that fall on the good soil, free of, no persecutions, or at least can withstand the persecutions, no thorns, they've given up the cares of the world and the pleasures of the world, and there's nothing but fertile soil. They not only grow deep roots, they not only germinate, but they grow into plants that produce not just the normal amount of fruit, but 100 times more fruit than they should be capable of. And today is May 14th from the Franciscan Daily Companion. He who wishes to have peace and quiet should esteem in every person his superior. He who wishes to have peace and quiet should esteem every person his superior. That is the Blessed Giles of Assisi. Reflection. Who is the most important person in the world, in our lives? Blessed Giles reminds us that we should consider everyone else to be more important than we are. The question should never be, how can I make my life more comfortable? It should be, what can I do for others to show them how much I respect them? Lord, may I honor and respect all of your children. Our Father, your kingdom come on earth as in heaven. Ruler of the everlasting kingdom, Prince of Peace, Champion of the despised, you are the King. You make a cross your throne, you wear a crown of thorns, you call your subjects friends. Help us to take up our cross, to hunger and thirst for all that is good. Then will your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. God, grant us the serenity to accept the things we cannot change, the courage to change the things we can, and the wisdom to know the difference. God of life, be with us throughout this day, whether or not it brings us joy. Help us, when evening comes, to recall one benefit from which you give to... Help us, when evening comes, to recall one benefit for which to give you thanks. Amen. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. God's mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Your faithfulness, O Lord, is great. You are all that I have, and therefore I will wait for you. You are all that I have, and therefore I will wait for you. You, Lord, are good to those who wait for you, to all those who seek you. It is good to wait in patience for the salvation of the Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. So as always, whenever there is a moment of silence between prayers or after petitions, it is your invitation to insert whatever petitions or prayers you would like to insert. If you want to make them public for others to pray for you as well, you can write them in the comments. Okay? Don't be too detailed if it's like something long that and involved. Just sort of give it general. You know, here's what I'm praying for, you know, for this, not going into the whole detail. Like if you're having an issue with like a family member, don't go into the whole argument or whole issue, but just say, hey, for a resolution for, you know, for peace within my family or something like that. Okay. So in peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with your truth and love and be found without fault at the day of your coming, we pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For our presiding bishop, for all bishops and other ministers, and for all the holy people of God, we pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Jesus Christ, that our divisions may cease, and that all may be one as you and the Father are one. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among the peoples, we pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those in positions of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote your dignity and freedom and the freedom of every person. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For a blessing upon all human labor and for the right use of the riches of creation, that the world may be freed from poverty, famine, and disaster. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For this congregation, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth your glory in all that we do. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For our enemies and those who wish us harm, and for all whom we have injured or offended. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For ourselves, for the forgiveness of our sins, and for the grace of the Holy Spirit to amend our lives. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all who have commended themselves to our prayers, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being freed from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all who have died in the communion of your church, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints, they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but eternal life. We pray to you, O Lord. Lord, have mercy. Rejoicing in the fellowship of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God, to you, O Lord our God. Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and on earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Holy and ever-living God, by your power we are created, and by your love we are redeemed. Guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that we may give ourselves to your service, and live this day in love to one another and to you. Through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May we continue to dwell in Christ so that when he appears, we may be confident and unashamed before him at his coming. Amen. Hallelujah. And that's morning prayer for this morning. Peace and all good, beloved. I hope you have a very good day, and I'll see you next time.